I will not go there, of course, until you are there.
Do you come?
Well, Americans are rather sensitive to my entertainment. Do they find it?
If you don't ask for it, then buy it.
I'll inquire about it.
What?
How's the prettiest girl to come?
There is for you in that way. No, that is not quite
good. It is.
I told you at least would not taste like that.
Good. But there's none other more handy. I did not mean that quite.
Are you withdrawing the compliment?
Reinforcing it, maybe. Something is pretty when it misses the eye. It's more than that when...
Exactly. It must be ugly.
Always?
No, of course, you are right.
Why did you say this is the last time?
I am going to go.
When? For what?
For your approaching wedding. I should have offered congratulations long before. But you know, my visitors are slow getting about the news.
Are weddings interesting to you?
When they are of friends, yes.
Would you come if I ask you?
When is it going to be?
May.
May is the month of happiness, they say.
They say. Would you come?
Why not?
No reason. I'm just asking. Then you will.
If you will ask me.
Then I ask you.
Then I will be there.
I wish that house were mine, that all the bewilderments of the present were not, and that this woman by my side were my long-wedded wife, returning with me to the peace of home.
Rita, did you ever have to do something you wanted to do and something you had to do?
No.
I thought maybe you had that experience, then you could understand a man who was in such a situation. You are fortunate.
Is this man sure of what he should do?
I don't know, Lolita. Perhaps not. But there's a point where things keeps us and rushes downward of its own will, dragging us along. And it is foolish to ask whether one or will not, because it no longer depends on him.
But then why? Why? Oh, what do I know? That is his problem after all.
Isn't it? The rest of you?
Why must it? I have to say goodbye, Mr. Salazar. We were at the house.
Had the final word been said? It had. Yet a feeble flutter of hope. 3 years of engagement. A very near wedding. Perfect understanding between my parents. My own conscience. And Esperanza herself. Esperanza waiting. Esperanza no longer young. Esperanza the efficient, the literal-minded, the intensely acquisitive.
Alfredo, are you listening?
Well, what of it?
She is not married to him. Besides, she should have thought of us. Nanay practically brought her up. We never thought she would turn out bad.
What had Calixta done? Only middle-aged Calixta? You are very positive about her badness.
But do you approve?
Of what?
What she did.
No.
Well...
All I say is that it's not necessarily weak.
Why shouldn't it be? You talk like an immoral man. I did not know that your ideas were like that.
My ideas? The only test I wish to apply to conduct is the test of fairness. Am I injuring anybody? No?
Then I am justified in my conscience. I am right, living with a man to whom she is not married. Is that it? It may be wrong, and again it may not.
She has injured us. She was ungrateful.
The trouble with you, Esperanza, is that you are.
Wait till you get angry. I do not understand you at all. I think I know why you have been indifferent to me lately. I'm not blind or deaf. I see and hear what perhaps some are trying to keep from me. Why do you speak up frankly before it's too late? You need not think of me and what people will say.
Yes, one tries to be fair to oneself first, but that is too easy. One does not dare.
What do you mean? Whatever my shortcomings, and no doubt they are many in your eyes, I have never gone out of my way, of my place, to find a man.
Esperanza, if you suppose I...
If you mean you want to take back of your word, if you are tired of... Why did you tell me you are tired of me?
How would life seem now if I had married Julia Salas? Had I meant anything to her? She had not married. Why? Faithfulness was not a conscious effort or regretful memory. It was something unvolitional, maybe a recurrent awareness of irreplaceability.
Good evening.
Good evening. Are you in town?
On some little business.
Won't you come up?
Just wait for me, I'll just prepare a call.
Thank you.
So how is your stay in our town?
It's just fine.
She had not changed much. A little less slender. Not so eagerly alive. Yet something had gone. What had she lost? Or was the lost mine? So that was all over. Why had I obstinately clung to that dream? So all these years, since when? I had been seeing the light of dead stars, long extinguished, yet seemingly still in their appointed places in the heavens.